The chairman of this occasion, the president general of the union, our federal house of representatives member here, and his royal highness is here. I want to stand on the existing protocol and quickly move with military precision. Within 10 minutes, I want to be done. I know we have all had patience, but I must say that nke mbade na ahuhu mo de nihi sike mo de in any form of problem or the other, and when we summit, banke we may discuss, because what are you going home to do? You are going home to that same problem. So let us be patient and discuss among ourselves. Let us not run out of this summit. Many of us, Bali, to make contact, one of the important of platforms is that it provides you opportunity to network. I won't only for us to just come and give speeches here. There are some people you may meet in Ankara, your life will change. There are some contacts and network you will make here. Some problems in the Lucky Land will be solved. So let us not be in a hurry. Lights have been provided. Anybody I can call it. So let's be patient. But on my own part, I will finish very quickly. I want to thank the President General of Ndoki Union for, keep it. I was feeling hot, so I have to remove the cap. For the opportunity to be in this summit, it's a great honor for me. And I was given the topic, Ndoki Safety Amidst Security Challenges. I am an Ihedeme in Nigeria. That's why I cannot read my paper. I've just tried to bring out the import of the paper. Because I'm going to ask, I will take up to 30 minutes. So, I'm in Nigeria. And it boils down to one point, one factor, which I'm going to mention. From what is happening in the northeast to the northwest, now, Nigeria is becoming a center for jihadists to have space to operate, criminal elements to have space to operate. And it boils down to one factor, ungoverned spaces. Ungoverned spaces. Only I remember in the northwest, Sokoto, Katsina, Kebbi State, Kaduna, they are all gone. You cannot travel safely. The Northeast, it has always been a region for marauders and bandits, cattle rustlers, and criminal elements like that. Why? There are a lot and lot of ungoverned spaces. And what do criminals want? Where lay a place to hibernate, a safe haven, a guy who may disturb. That's all criminals want. And once they have that space, it's only a matter of time. The responsible people in the community will run away. And that is the import of my paper. How do we ensure Ndoki's safety in the midst of this insecurity? It is to avoid ungoverned spaces. This is the summary of my paper. And I will just bring out a few challenges and go into the suggested solution. And then I am done because of our time. What are the challenges? Ungoverned spaces. Or what is causing ungoverned spaces? There's always that, unexplained hesitance by those whose responsibility it is to nip things in the bud immediately they are rising. We see a lot of food dragging that we cannot explain. So that contributes a lot to the ungoverned spaces. Another challenge is inadequate security personnel. The total number of security personnel in Nigeria is not up to 150,000. Combine all of them, Army, Navy, everybody, including immigration, customs. And imagine the size of Nigeria. Don't forget that the current map of Africa is wrong. I saw a write-up on it, and I can allude to it. Because when I went to the Northeast to fight Boko Haram for 2 years, if you see this swath of land there, you agree with me that the map of Nigeria is currently wrong. Somebody made that assertion in the internet recently, how the map of Africa was wrongly drawn in favor of Europe and the Americas. He traveled from the far west of Africa onto the far east and found out that it contains much more than you can see on the map. So I'm wearing a lot of spaces that cannot be governed because of the size of our land and inadequate security personnel. That is a major problem. So don't ever think that we have enough security personnel to take care of our problems. Then, coupled or adding to the security, the inadequate security personnel is lack of equipment of security personnel. We are inadequately equipped. And one of the problems is that we don't produce our own arms. That's why you see that there's a lot of efforts being made presently to generate locally grown military industrial complex to enable us to produce some of our arms. Because sometimes when we are in dire straits, political and other considerations stop foreign countries from selling arms to us. We are stranded. And so we cannot control the impulse of war. And by so doing, we cannot be efficient. So just know, inadequate security personnel, insufficient equipping of security forces. Then, having concluded with what is creating these ungoverned spaces or exacerbating it, because it's already existing, we now have in our hands growing unemployed population. People are coming out of school in unbelievable numbers and there are no jobs. There are no jobs. You see children everywhere. And then drug abuse. This Ikurumiri and other drug abuse is exacerbating the difficulty to control our youths, being already unemployed. And then breakdown of community values. People, you hear unimaginable things that happen in the society now. People can kill and roast people. You know, things you cannot imagine will happen. So, all these are the challenges going on. What is the way forward for Ndoki security? I have 4 points, and I want us to take note of it. Mobilize, organize, codify, and execute. Mobilize, organize, codify, and execute. Since we have identified the major problem is on governance spaces and the inability of security agencies to cover everywhere, we need to mobilize our communities. Mobilizing the communities, this is a part of it. And then we go down to our various communities and have meetings like this and let everybody understand that there is a growing menace of ungoverned spaces, which is allowing criminal elements to take up the void. So every community must be properly organized, must be mobilized and then organized. When you mobilize and have discussions like these and meetings in town halls, you now organize. Whichever way you choose to do it, His Royal Highness have mentioned CDC, that's Community Development Councils. Now there should be the council, the youth group, which should incorporate the vigilante, or have the elders forum, and anyhow you want to organize it, but make sure you have the youth group or the vigilante who will be the execution arm for the village, and this every village must have it. This is very important because once your village is taken over by criminal elements because you are not organized, they find ungoverned spaces and take up spaces, they will begin to organize themselves better than the village. Before you know it, insecurity will creep in. And give them 1, 2, 3 months, and the thing festers. One day I'm going to have some at the community. So, any community that hasn't done so must quickly do so. That is how we are going to ensure the safety in the midst of this insecurity. So when you have organized into this group, you must codify it. That is the third point. Mobilize, organize, codify. You must quickly put up whatsoever constitution or laws that will govern the community. You must write it down and have it registered in the court. Codify it. A copy should be in the nearest police station, if that is necessary. I had to make a lot of efforts that my community did this. Because there were a lot of problems, you know, just like Onyeze mentioned to us, you know, the difficulty in maintaining the succession of the royalty, and whether on the private side that he mentioned, although I didn't understand that one, but there is difficulty of succession in many of the communities, and everybody is running riot. So what we did was we avoided that royalty issue. We say, okay, let's leave this one. We cannot fight about it. Let us set up an effective community development council. Have them elected by the people. We came to the town hall and elected the council. Decide the position that is going to be elected. And elect them and empower them to run the community. Then have the youth group. The youth group will incorporate the vigilante. They are the executive arm. Once anybody does any nonsense, they go after him. There should be no gap. Don't give any gap. Don't give any chance for criminal elements to start organizing. Some people will go and set up checkpoints and be collecting small money. And before you know it now, you know, the transport fare along that route will increase. Your kind of people will add money. One day they can kidnap somebody from there if they want more. So don't give any gap for criminals or people that are not part of the community structure to set up themselves. So the youth and the vigilante must be very active in going after them. Once there is a set of criminal elements that are overpowering them, then you people would have had arrangements with a nearby police station or military unit. I'm a military unit in Azumini, Mekwa 1, somewhere here in Akwete, I believe. So you must do some background work in liaising with them so that they can reinforce your youth and vigilante group. Once they are meeting organized criminal elements that are a little more powerful than them, you need to get the support of the state security to overpower them, so that we can have communities that are integral, that can govern themselves, you know, based on whatever is the tradition of that community. They're very organized. So what about all these things, like we did in Abaki? I know many of you already have it. I'm just using it to make my point. What about that? And then have the youth active and ready to execute whatsoever is in this constitution. With that, we'll be able to secure our various communities. There are so many things I have to say about personal security. We all know it. Many of us that are in WhatsApp platforms, you see all these things shared. But I don't have time to discuss all of them. I will stop here. I want to thank the President General for inviting me. Thank you very much.
General.